waited for this day. We're gathered in your name, calling out to you. Your glory like a fire, awakening desire, will burn our hearts with truth. You're the reason we're here. You're the reason we're singing. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. Your presence in this place, your glory on our face, we're looking to the skies. Descending like a cloud, you're standing with us now. Lord, unveil our eyes, 'cause you're the reason we're here. You're the reason we're singing. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart and filling every part of our praise. Show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory, Lord. Show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory, Lord, and open up the heavens. We want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart and filling every part.
Please join me in the call to worship. Your part is the bold print. This comes from Hebrews 12, verses 1 and 2. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, and let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us. Who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, rejoice, the Lord is King. Your Lord and King adore. Mortals, give thanks and sing and triumph evermore. Lift up your heart, lift up your voice, rejoice again, I say, rejoice. Jesus the Savior reigns, the God of truth and love. When he had purged our stains, he took his seat above. Lift up your heart, Lift up your voice, rejoice, again I say, rejoice. His kingdom cannot fail, he rules o'er earth and heaven. The keys of earth and hell are to our Jesus given. Lift up your heart, lift up your voice, rejoice, again I say, rejoice. Rejoice in glorious hope, Jesus the Judge shall come and take his servants up to their eternal home. We soon shall hear the archangel's voice, the trump of God shall sound, rejoice. Welcome to this online worship service for Liddish United Methodist Church and Brunnerville United Methodist Church. My name is Steve Rogers. I'm pastor of Brunnerville United Methodist Church, and I'm the pastor of congregational care and music here at Liddish United Methodist Church. We're so glad you've joined us today. We do these joint worship services so that we can stay connected with you at home, and we're so thankful that you're able to be a part of this worship service. We're also worshiping live on Sunday morning, and you are welcome to attend as well. If you'd like to attend at Liddish United Methodist Church, we do ask that you make a reservation, or you may come and see if there's any room left. Brunnerville United Methodist Church is open for you to come and worship with us. Liddish United Methodist Church meets at 9:30 a.m. on Sunday morning, and Brunnerville at 10:30 a.m. We do want to let you know that we have an opening here at Liddish United Methodist Church. Cliff Neal, our esteemed media director, is going to be concentrating more on his day job. And so we do have an opening for media director. If you have interest in that or know someone who might be interested in that position in any way, please contact us here at Liddish United Methodist Church. Also want to let you know that Pastor Jerry is on vacation this week, and so you'll be seeing him again next week. But we are glad that you're here, no matter whether you're online or whether you're listening Sunday morning or whenever during the week. Thank you for being a part of this worship service, and thank you for being a part of Liddish United Methodist Church and Brunnerville United Methodist Church.
Beholding your beauty is all that I long for. To worship you, Jesus, is my sole desire. For this very heart you have shaped for your pleasure, purpose to lift your name high. Here in surrender and pure adoration, enter your courts with an offering of praise. I am your servant, come to bring you glory, as is fit for the work of your hands. Now unto the Lamb who sits on the throne be glory and honor and praise. All of creation sounds with the song, worship and praise him, the Lord of lords. Spirit now living and dwelling within me, keep my eyes fixed ever on Jesus' face. Let not the things of this world ever sway me, I'll run till I finish the race. Singing unto the Lamb who sits on the throne be glory and honor and praise. All of creation resounds with the song, worship and praise the Lord. Sits on the throne be glory and honor. us a song. Worship and praise Him, the Lord of Lords. Holy Lord, You are holy. Jesus Christ is the Lord.
Friends, we're going to join in a time of prayer. Of course, we want to pray for all those affected by this virus and pandemic. There are many businesses, particularly restaurants, which are having a tough go of it during this time. And the nursing homes, which have thankfully made progress, but still have some cases of the virus. We're going to pray for those folks there. And for members of your family who may be ill or may be struggling in other ways with this. We also want to lift up Liz Steele, who's having surgery on her knee on August 17th. Georgia Bishop, who's now a resident at Moravian Manor. Corrine Russo, a friend of many in this congregation, who had surgery this past week on Wednesday. And Diane Bergner, as she continues her recovery and is making much progress. Let's pray for these and other folks, Lord, other folks to the Lord as we come together in prayer. Let us pray. We thank You, God, for Your grace, Your love, Your peace, Your strength. We thank You, Lord, for Your guidance in our lives and for the hope we have because of Your love for us. We thank You that we can come to You and pray this morning and indeed every day and bring our concerns and our joys and share them with You. Lord, as we gather today, we do pray for these we have mentioned, for those recovering from surgery, Lord, that You'd strengthen them and heal them. For those who are entering the nursing home or the many residents we have in nursing homes, Lord, that You would watch over them, keep them safe, and help them to feel Your presence, even when they're separated from their family during this time. We pray, Lord, for those who are recovering from surgery and ask that You'll continue to bless them and lift them up. And we pray, God, that all those who are facing whatever medical situation, that You would just give them peace, help them to know Your strength. Father, as we have gathered in these many weeks in these online services, and now as we begin to gather in person as well on Sunday morning, we're thankful for Your grace and Your sustaining love through this time. And we pray that You'll continue to guide us as congregations and as individual servants of You, that we might continue to show grace to those around us, to be safe, and to show our concern for others in whatever way we can. We pray Your blessing on our churches, God, through this difficult time, and the many churches in our communities, each one facing difficulty, each one trying to determine what the best route is in this pandemic, each one seeking to serve You and to serve those around us. Father, we pray for the leaders of our nation and our world, and ask that you'll give them wisdom, not only that, but you'll help them to follow it and help them to know what is best for their entire constituents and to be able to have the courage, Lord, to follow that. Pray, God, for our nation in particular, as we go through so much division, so much controversy, we go through protests, as we go through various struggles in our streets, in our cities, in our countryside. Lord, we pray that your peace would settle on us all and that your love would be our guide, that we would be able to work with each other and cooperate and find hope in you. We thank you, God, for all the ways in which you bless us, all the ways in which you give us hope, and all the ways we can count on you, which we do, Lord, in the name of Christ, as we pray together that prayer he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
You have walked me through the valley of the shadows dark and low, and that's reason enough to believe. You have shown me endless mercy, oh, why I'll never know, and that's reason enough to believe. So I won't wait for signs and wonders to teach me how to trust, 'cause you've already proven, Lord, the depths of your great love.
You took the cross of your precious blood,
and that's reason enough to believe. Yes, that's reason enough for me.
When I took your grace for granted, I was granted even more, and that's reason enough to believe.
Oh, and with compassion you convinced me I'm not hopeless anymore, and that's reason enough to believe.
So I won't wait for signs and wonders to teach me how to trust, 'cause you've already proven, Lord, the depths of your great love.
You took the cross so willingly and spilled your precious blood,
and that's reason enough to believe. Yes, that's reason enough for me. That's reason.
We want to thank you for the many ways in which you bless our two churches through your offerings, especially in this time when the CARES Act money has now ended. We are thankful because you are the ones who keep our ministries going. If you'd like to send your offering into Liturgy United Methodist Church or to Brunnerville United Methodist Church, the addresses are on the screen. Also, you can give online to Liturgy United Methodist Church, and the information of that is on the website as well. We thank you for your offerings. Most of all, we thank you for your prayers and for your generous spirit as we continue to deal with this pandemic, as we continue to be in ministry in our community. Thank you.
Standing, I'm standing by the river deep and wide, and I am a-gazing, I'm a-gazing across the tide, the raging tide, and I'm standing by the river, trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side, Standing on the banks of the river, looking beyond, Standing on the banks of the river, looking for my home, just to get a glimpse of my Jesus and that home up there on high, looking for the light of my Savior up in the sky. Standing, I'm standing by the river deep and wide. I am gazing, across the tide, the raging tide, and I am standing, by the river, trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side, Standing there waiting for the boatman, ready to go, Standing there waiting for the boatman, onto that shore, Just to get a glimpse of that city, and behold my Savior there. Then I'll know forever I'll be in my Savior's care.
I was standing on the banks when I saw that old ship take my mama home. I was standing on the banks when Daddy crossed the river and he left me all alone.
Now I'm standing on the banks waiting for my ride to heaven's golden shore. And I'm trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side.
Oh, now I'm standing, by the river and I am gazing. Across the tide, the raging tide, and I am standing, by the river, trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side,
Trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other, trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other, by the river deep and wide, and I am a-gazing, across the tide, the raging tide, and I am standing, by the river, trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side, Standing, by the river deep and wide, and I am a-gazing, across the tide, the raging tide, and I am standing, by the river, trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other, trying to get a glimpse of what's over
on the other side,
on the other side.
The scripture reading today is from Paul's letter to the Thessalonians, the first letter, and it's chapter 1, verses 1 through 10. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the church of the Thessalonians in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor of love and steadfastness of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that He has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with full conviction. Just as you know what kind of persons we proved to be among you for your sake. And you became imitators of us and of the Lord. For in spite of persecution, you received the word with joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit, so that you became an example to all the believers in Macedonia and in Achaia. For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report about us what kind of welcome we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve a living and true God, and to wait for His Son from heaven, whom He raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescues us from the wrath to come. As the Lititz vocal band just sang, I'm just standing here trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side of this pandemic. As we've begun to meet back together in person again, and as we continue to share in these online worship services, I'm just trying to see with our 2020 vision how we're going to run this race, trying to get past the virus and the difficulties that this virus has brought upon us. For we know that the COVID-19 is the result of a highly contagious virus. We've made all kinds of modifications to our worship space here and our procedures to mitigate as much as possible any spreading of that virus here at church, whether at Lititz or Brunnerville Church. But we must remain vigilant because the coronavirus is still around and is still contagious. In fact, the only thing more contagious than the virus is fear. We have fear of the shutdowns and limited inside seating. We have fear of the economic hardships that many of us face through all of this. We have fears of how safe the schools will be when and if they open in just a few weeks. Some have fears of the stock market dropping or of bankrupt businesses, of continued working from home, of the social distancing rules, or even fears of wearing a mask. Some fear the shortage of Lysol. And we have fears of whether our churches will survive, of whether our vulnerable members of our families will survive, of whether our nation will survive. And then there is the fear I have, and perhaps some of you share, since I have a vulnerable person at home. I wonder each day, am I contagious? Did I catch this thing somewhere and I'm now bringing it home? Can I be any more careful? What if I've been close to someone who was sick? What if I have it? What if it spreads? What if I'm a carrier and I don't know it? These fears are real to many people, and perhaps you share some of them. But my friends, I'm here today to tell you it's time to cast off our fear and to get back into the race. Our call to worship says from Hebrews 12, verse 1, let us lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely, and let us get back in and run with perseverance the race that's set before us, following Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith. Friends, I hope you can understand my fears about being a carrier. However, the point here I'm trying to make is that I am a carrier. Now, I know some of you are going to be backing away from your computer screen right now. But, my friends, it's also true that you are a carrier. You and I are carrying something. And when people get near you and get near me, they catch what we have. You are a carrier. I am a carrier. And the question is what we are carrying worth catching? Are you just carrying the fears that entangle us and trip us up? Are you carrying the burdens of lost chances and of past wrong decisions? Do you feel the weight of negative possibilities and potential failures? Are you immobilized by the pain and the pressure and the worries of life? Well, I understand that, friends, and especially in the midst of this pandemic, there is much to fear. And these legitimate fears can arrest us and swamp us and knock us down. But, as I said before, it's time to move on. It's time to get back in the race. It's time to acknowledge the past, yes. Acknowledge the pressure, yes. Acknowledge the fear, yes. But then to realize that we can either let all that pass, let all that pressure, let all that fear paralyze us, or we can accept it as part of life now and move on and start running towards the finish once more. So what is this race we are in? What is this goal line we seek? Well, in our scripture that was just read, the Apostle Paul was writing to followers of Jesus in the city of Thessalonica, which is in modern-day Greece. These believers in Jesus were in a situation that might be a little similar to ours today. They too were facing all sorts of trials. They too were in a position where it was easy to be afraid. But this is what the Apostle Paul said to them. 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 2 and 3. He said, "We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and your labor of love and your steadfastness of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ." You see, Paul said they had faith, love, and hope. And why did they have faith, love, and hope? Was it because of what was going on in their world, the scary and difficult things that were happening around them? No, of course not. They had faith, they had love, they had hope in spite of those things around them, because of the one who was Lord over their world, the one who had their lives in his hands. They had faith, they had love, they had hope because of Jesus Christ. My friends, we can too. Faith, love, and hope. I think that about sums it up for the Christian, doesn't it? That defines a pretty good goal for us, don't you think? And that can describe the finish line that we are running for today. It's a race where we could, first of all, in the midst of the stresses of this world situation, with all the distractions and pressures all around us, where we could focus on growing our faith in Christ. And secondly, it's a race where, in the midst of the partisan divides that are fracturing our nation and our communities, we could more and more respect and show our concern for others, showing them the way not of division, but the way of love instead of hate and violence. It's a race, thirdly, where we could share the hope that we have, even in the midst of a pandemic, the hope and assurance and peace that we have in our life, both here and forever, because of Jesus. These threefold summary of living as a Christian, faith and love and hope, would be pretty good news right about now, don't you think? And as verse 5 of 1 Thessalonians 1 continues, says, Paul says, our message of the gospel, the good news, came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with full conviction. In the same way, our message, our goal is good news. And like a positive virus, this good news can spread all around the world. Paul's description of the Thessalonians goes on in verses 7 and 8. He said, you became an example to all the believers in Macedonia and Achaia, for the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has become known. Wow. What if our faith became so contagious that wherever we went, we found people talking about it? What if our love for others was so profound that people everywhere were noticing how much we respect them, how much we care for them? What if our hope in Jesus was so sure that those around us and all those they come in contact with knew that they could rely on the very real peace and presence of God in these very troubled times? Friends, the reality is that you are a carrier, and I am a carrier. And the question is what we are carrying worth catching? Are we carriers of good news? Are we spreading this virus of God's faith, love, and hope? Are we running to win the race for Jesus? Let us pray. Gracious God, our one and only Savior and friend, as you have led us through and continue to lead us through these difficult times, we are grateful for your spirit of power, your spirit of conviction. We pray that as we share that faith and love and hope with those around us and with those around the world, that you would live through that and live into those people's lives and draw them to yourself and help us to make a difference in their lives because of your love. In Jesus' name, amen.
And fearless prophet of ancient Galilee, thy life is still a summons to serve humanity, to make our thoughts and actions less prone to please the crowd, to stand with humble courage for truth with hearts unbowed. We marvel at the purpose that held thee to thy course, whenever on the hilltop before thee loomed the cross. Thy steadfast face set forward where love and duty shone, and so you head the upward way, but tread the path alone. Stir up in us a vision, a passion truly felt, for those who starve and hunger and plead for work and health, where homes with little children cry out for lack of bread, who live their lives sore burdened beneath a gloomy dread. O young and fearless pride,
presence here amid our pride and glory to see thy face appear. Once more to hear thy challenge above our noisy day, again to lead us forward along God's holy way. And now, friends, in the strength that Jesus gives you, run the race in faith. Love those who are running alongside of you, and bring hope to the world. In Jesus' name, amen.